Whereas I've got to get, sometimes it takes me ages and I've got to get out and I've got to get touch up because my face is so wet. So, have you had a good time?
Yeah!
So have I. You really have been the best crowd so far. You've been so lovely. Next song that I'm going to do for you, we're not quite at the end, but we nearly are, and it's lovely that you all, it's lovely that you all come down to the front as well, it's nice to see you a bit clearer. But this next one, let me get me hot honey, just in case you were wondering what I was drinking, it's just boring hot honey. But I am going to have a glass of wine in about 9 minutes. This next one, I'm a long time in between my last album and this album, which I'm sure some of you probably know about anyway, but I had a kid, I was just bumming around, like, I had a kid, and I had an amazing time with him, and I wanted to make sure I had that bond with him before I came out. This was in the pipeline, and then I got pregnant, so I didn't do it then because I was pregnant and stuff like that, and I wanted to have that, you know, that mother and son bond with him before I came out to do this, and I got it, so thank you very much for saying hello to me when I came back. And I felt like I'd lost my mojo a little bit, not just in my songwriting, but in like every element of my life. I'm a bit emotional because I'm worried I might never play you again. I've been in the office for a few years, so I'm worried that when I come back you'll be like, fuck off. Amazing this life, but it's not real life, and you know, no one wants you to believe me and stuff like that. But anyway, I was worried that I wasn't going to be able to write a song that I believed in, and if I didn't believe it, then I would never let anybody else hear it for anyone else to maybe believe me. And then I wrote a few songs, and I've like half loads of time off, and well, for fuck's sake, I might as well start singing. It's a bit more admirable if you try when you sing, I feel like, rather than like cry, stop, place right now. I didn't have the song that gave me the confidence to be like, right, I'm ready to come back, like, you know, the most important thing to me now is being mum, and before it was being a singer and stuff like that. And I lacked the song, and I was happy with the rest of the songs on the album, but I simply wouldn't have put the album out until I had the song that really, really resonated with me. I wrote pretty much all of the record in London, and then I decided to go to LA for, you know, some vitamin D, really. I actually have a sufficiency. I actually do have a sufficiency. You should see how pale my legs are. I've got a lot of makeup on my face. It makes me look more tired than I am. So I went there, proper bricks abroad, you know, out back to the palm trees. And then 2 days later, I wrote this song. And you can imagine how fucking relieved I was. Oh my God, I was so relieved. It's my favourite song I've ever written. And it really, really, really resonated with how I felt then and how I wanted to feel again, how I didn't want to feel, how I used to feel, like every emotion. And I wrote it with another artist who is so amazing. His name's Tobias Gesso Jr. And if you haven't heard of him, you should check him out, because I think you love him. If you like my music, I think you like him. He's so good as fuck as well. And so he's amazing. He's Canadian, actually. Any Canadian? You must know him. He's wonderful. And this is the song. Yeah, this is the song that, again, a bit like Someone Like You, for a different reason, it changed my life. It brought me back to life and gave me my identity. So sing along if you know it.